Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Rhian. I bring you kind of lifestyle-y, cruelty-free, vegan beauty, mental health, a little bit of everything type of videos on my channel. So I do hope you will stick around and subscribe if you haven't already. For today's video, I'm going to be doing something in the mental health vein of things, which is going to be talking to you about my GeneSight test results. So just a little bit of background information on me. If you have been watching my channel for a while, you might want to skip past this part, but I have had several mental health diagnoses throughout my life, which started probably when I was about 13, 12, maybe, which started with generalized anxiety disorder, clinical depression, and then it wasn't until a little bit later on, probably when I was about 19 or 20, I think, that I got a diagnosis of cyclothymia, which is kind of a lesser version of bipolar. Cyclothymia and like generalized anxiety disorder, I guess, are my diagnoses. And over the years, I've tried some drugs, and if you came to watch this video to tell me that I need to suck it up and that drugs aren't going to fix anything, please just don't bother, just go somewhere else. So it wasn't until recently that actually my husband first did this test. Yes, we're both mental. The test itself is called GeneSight. I will link you to their website down below, and essentially what it does is uses a DNA sample of yours to tell you which drugs you are most likely to tolerate well and which you are not likely to tolerate well. My husband had done it already through a different doctor, and then I had asked my family doctor if he would consider ordering the test for me, which he was completely open to. He knows I have cycled through a lot of medications in my time, and so especially for us living fairly remotely where there is very, very poor access to mental health professionals, I think tests like this are super important to reduce the guesswork that your already overly stretched family doctors have to do when it comes to more specialized things like this. I most recently have been taking a medication called mirtazapine, which has worked well for me and basically done what I needed it to, which was enable me to sleep and eat and just continue on with life, even though I've been having some more situational things going on top of my existing chronic mental health condition. I have been taking mirtazapine. It has done everything I've needed it to, but I do not think this is one I can take long term because weight gain has been an issue with it. And although I am kind of like making peace with my body and the weight gain as I go, I don't think it's probably going to be healthy to do long term. And also some of those life stressors had started to wind down. So that was the reason why I asked my doctor to do this test, was because I've tried and failed a bunch of medications before, and I really do want to make sure the next thing I try is going to be, I mean, nothing is guaranteed, right? There's always a chance you might not tolerate something well, but I wanted to take a really educated stab at the next medication. So I asked my doctor if he would do it. He said yes. I have these results from him. Now, because like I mentioned, my husband has done the test before and I went through the whole results thing with him, I have a basic understanding of how to read this. Now, I am also going to have an appointment with my doctor to go over anything that hasn't happened just yet, but it is scheduled. I just wanted to kind of tell you guys about this because I feel like it could be super helpful for a lot of you, and I had mentioned it before. So I took the test, I think, last Wednesday, and then Monday I had the results. So all I did was go into my doctor. The nurse actually did it with me. The packet just consists of two long cotton swabs, like the cotton swabs they would use for anything medically. You swipe one of the cotton swabs in each cheek, I think for like 10 swipes each or something like that. They put them in the envelope, send them off. I think the place is based in Ohio, which is, you know, not that far from me. It's in the Midwest. The results were extremely fast. Before we get into this, I do just want to say that for some people, this may seem like, wow, you're like too invested in this, or that it's like an obsessive thing to pursue. But I think unless you've had like health issues or like chronic health conditions, you don't understand how useful this information can be. If you think I'm too invested in this, whatever, just don't watch this video. The workup that you get will show you different types of medication, so antidepressants, anti-anxiety medications, stuff like that, and you will get them in three columns, which will be basically like green, amber, and red. So green is like the best meds for you. The amber section is a moderate gene-drug interaction, and then the red section is a significant gene-drug interaction. So the first page of mine is antidepressants, which I have taken a fair few of in my time. So mine is printed in black and white, but in the green section, as you can see, I have a bunch of options. So what I did was just go ahead and highlight any meds I know I've already tried and taken, so I could kind of like visually be like, okay, that one didn't work out, that makes sense. I have a lot of green options in antidepressants, one of which I have taken before and I think tolerated fairly well other than weight gain, is Prozac. Mirtazapine, which is what I'm taking now, is also in the green section. So, I mean, that's good to know. That's, I feel like that's like a fairly good control. Moving into moderate gene-drug interactions, I have two medications in there which I have taken before, which are citalopram and then escitalopram. I may be saying these in the British way, I don't know. Both of which I do think I had weight gain with, but I also had the like zombie fuzz. You'll know what I mean if you've been there. Moving on to the red section, which is the significant gene-drug interaction section, I have three in there, one of which I was taking for several years, which is bupropion or Wellbutrin. Now, I actually really loved Wellbutrin for dealing with my depression. The depression has always been a more, a bigger part of my condition, I guess, in what's affected me more. I only ever typically had like maybe hypomania at most, but the depression was always more of an issue for me. And I felt that Wellbutrin really did help with the depression. I felt much more level in that sense. I didn't feel quite so emotional and heightened. But the interesting thing with this, and this is what my doctor did say to me on the phone, is that this would explain why when I first started taking Wellbutrin, I honestly went through like 6 weeks of hell. And everything I read online was people being like, the first 6 weeks are super hard, but then it's so worth it. And so I just read that and pushed through. I was getting like immense panic attacks and just wild emotions those first 6 weeks while I kind of got used to it. Now looking back, maybe I shouldn't have continued on with it. I don't know, but that would explain that reaction. I also had tried to take a higher dose at one point, and I started to get really odd sensations in my skin. So we came back down on the dose. That could also be related to it. I am not going to pretend to know a lot about genetics, DNA, anything like that. But a lot of this is based on like the enzymes present and how that might affect things as well. So for Wellbutrin, it has a 1 and a 6 next to it, which means serum level may be too high, lower doses may be required, which would make sense as to why when I tried to take the higher dose, I felt like there was bugs under my skin. And then number 6 is use of this drug may increase risk of side effects, which I did have in those first 6 weeks. So that was the depression page. The next page on mine is anxiolytic and hypnotic drugs. So this is more like anti-anxiety drugs. I have taken 3 of the options on here. In the green zone, we have Buspar, which I have taken before, but I had taken it with bupropion. And when I started taking this, it worked wonders for my anxiety, but it gave me a very high heart rate. This may be something that I might want to like revisit because it could have been that the combination just wasn't good for me, but that is in the green zone. And then Ambien is also in the green zone, which I've taken before, like after surgery. And I felt like it actually made me kind of wired. Anyway, moving into the amber section, one of the options in here, which I have taken before, was Ativan. This is, again, a moderate gene-drug interaction. I haven't really had any of, like, the PAMs. I don't know if you guys know what I mean when I say that. Lots of them have the word PAM at the end. I haven't really taken much in the way of PAMs. Ativan is the only one I have taken, and I only had, like, a prescription for like 15 of them, and I took them over like a 6 month period. I guess I didn't really notice any interaction or anything like that, but all good information to know. Knowledge is power, as they say. The next section is antipsychotics, which I have never taken. I have one significant or red zone drug, which is olanzapine, which I've never taken. I have one moderate gene drug interaction, which is safras. Again, I've never taken any antipsychotics, so I can't really like use my experience as a control for that. The next page is mood stabilizers, which again, I have never taken, but lamotrigine or Lamictal, which I guess is like typically very well tolerated by a lot of people. For me, I have a significant gene drug interaction there, and everything else in that zone is in the green zone. When my husband had taken this test, these next few pages are something that we completely overlooked and didn't really read because I didn't feel like they made a lot of sense. But the next two pages are your pharmacodynamic genes and your pharmacokinetic genes. This is my very basic understanding, is that pharmacodynamic is the drug's effect on the organism, and the pharmacokinetic is the organism's effect on the drug. So the first page, pharmacodynamic genes, basically everything on this page is normal. There are four options for different genes or possible like mutations, I guess. One of which is what your serotonin transporters look like, which mine are looking normal. One which is not super normal is that I have a polymorphism for the serotonin receptor type 2A, and I have two copies of, I think, the shit gene there, honestly. So that means I probably won't have great luck with SSRIs, which are serotonin reuptake inhibitors, because my receptors are faulty. I could have told you that. So not only does this test tell you which medications you are genetically likely to tolerate well or do well with, it also tells you things like what your serotonin transporters might look like and also what your receptors might be doing. I have two lower risk markers for severe reactions to medications. There's a thing called Steven-Johnson syndrome, which you can get with certain, I think that's more of antipsychotics, which I've never taken, but anyway, I have lower risks for those. The next page, which is the pharmacokinetic genes or the organism's effect on the drug, this is how you metabolize things. So on this page, it will have different sections with the different codes up here, which are your allele enzymes or something like that. Anyway, it will tell you whether you are a normal metabolizer, a poor metabolizer, etc. And then these codes are on the next couple of pages. And what you'll get are black dots in the columns for drugs that you probably won't tolerate very well. So that's kind of how to read these two pages. This one explains what those codes mean and what kind of metabolizer you are. And then on this page, it's got all of that information with the drug types. And any columns with black dots are ones that probably or potentially won't work for you. Now, each drug will have a different number of dots, and those are the different, again, this is my very basic understanding. These dots are the different enzymes needed to properly metabolize that drug. So, for example, on Buspar, we only have two dots, both of which mine are fine. Whereas on something like Trintellix, which I've never heard of before, I've got two black dots, so it's likely that I should pick another one. So those next few pages with the drugs and the different enzymes that may or may not be present or functioning in your body are going to be super helpful in picking the drug which is going to be safest for you genetically. So that's definitely something that could be super helpful for family doctors who are trying their best to, you know, play a psychiatrist. These next few sections are, I think, optional. So it's just something that I think your doctor can either check or not check. So my doctor also put in to get me the information on anesthetics and other stuff. So on here under opioids, I have one significant gene drug interaction, which is for Demerol, which I've never had. And then two of the green zone drugs, which I have taken, are hydrocodone and hydromorphone. Those are fine for me. Delauded, I gotta say, I was on top of the world. Again, the next page will just explain what kind of metabolizer you are with the different enzymes and such. So then you just have another page, exactly the same. You've got the different drugs, the different dots for anesthetics and opioid things. He also put me in to get the ADHD drug panel. I don't have any significant drug interactions, but I do have four moderate gene drug interactions. I've never taken any ADHD drugs, so I can't compare. The next page is just a follow-on from the ADHD drugs, saying what kind of response I would likely have to stimulant medications. The next page is for MTHFR, which to me looks like a rude abbreviation. But anyway, mine has a reduced folic acid conversion. So this is what that page will look like. Mine is reduced. It's not like the worst, but it's not great. And this is actually something I had never heard of before. It says the individual is heterozygous for the C677T polymorphism in the MTHFR gene. This genotype is associated with reduced folic acid metabolism, moderately decreased serum folate levels, and moderately increased homocysteine chapel levels. So this part for me was definitely a surprise, something I've never heard of before, but have kind of done some preliminary research into. The MTHFR mutations, I think, that you can have are linked to lots of health problems. Lots of them, a lot of which being mental health related. So that is interesting. And this is definitely something I'm going to go through with my doctor to learn a bit more about in regards as to whether should I be taking a supplement or should I avoid a supplement? Should I only be getting like plant folic acid? You know, it's sort of like a terrifying area. But definitely something I'm going to chat with my doctor about on that to find out a bit more about. I will say, if you are a chronic Googler, don't Google it, talk to your doctor first, because sometimes Google will have you thinking that you are dying. So, I'm a newsreader. So that was just kind of like going through my results, reading them with my very minimal knowledge on it. Like I said, I am going to have an appointment with my doctor, but I know myself, I need to take the time to look through this myself, research up what different things mean, and then I can go in there with a better understanding. Because if I just go in and I'm like trying to listen and taking on all the information, I have a really hard time processing everything. So like, this is really just like I learn in a very different way, so that's why I opted to take the information before my appointment, so I could like read into it and kind of process it a bit and have some basic knowledge before I go in and talk to him about it, because I always want to make sure I get like the most out of my doctor's appointments, because we're in America and they cost a lot of money. So definitely for me, this has been very informative as far as which drugs I should or should not pursue in the future when it comes to my mental health. Mother fricker gene mutation? Not sure about that. So that's something I'm going to trust that my doctor will explain to me. This is just something I wanted to bring up to you guys, because I know in talking about mental health, a lot of you have talked about how tough it's been finding the right medication, not being able to get a psychiatry appointment. So if this is something you can ask your family doctor to order for you, they may already have like an account with GeneSight. I just wanted to put this out there in hopes that it could be helpful to someone. You might be someone who doesn't like DNA testing and like knowing a lot about your genetics. But for me, I think knowledge is power when it comes to your health, especially as someone who has really struggled with like, I mean, I've got a chronic mental illness, you know? So those of you who are in a similar situation will know that sometimes dealing with your mental health condition is like a job in itself. I mean, not sometimes, it is. So having as much information as you possibly can and reducing the chances of going through horrible side effects, I think it's well worth it. GeneSight, I believe, is the price of it is based on your income, but that's definitely something to check on their website, which I will link below. I've been super impressed with the service. It was quick. I feel like it's given me a lot of information to go forward with, which that's really all you can ask for. And I think if you are in a similar situation to me, where you maybe live very remotely, there is not the mental health care that you feel that you need, just knowing on like a genetic level what you should or shouldn't take is going to be super helpful. So I really hope this was in some way interesting or informational to you guys, if only just to let you know how much information this test gives you. If you have already taken this test and you want to kind of share your thoughts on it or how you found it to be helpful, definitely let me know in the comments below. I will meet you down there. Please do give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I would love to have you, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.